out this little safe, and I've never, ever, ever been able to save money. Like, I literally $5 burn a hole in my fucking pocket, you know? And I'm like, oh, fuck it, I'll just go buy something for $5. But about a year ago, I started thinking, you know, I'm probably not getting any younger. And I don't do very good with investments. I mean, I always try to put money in every year and do the 401k thing. But I thought, you know, I wonder if just having some cash laying around anymore is not a half bad idea. So I just kind of started, and it's so funny. Like, when I start saving, it tends to just come to me, you know? It's like, here's $500, here's $1,000, here's $200. So I just been, I get it to where it's $1,000, and I put one of those little $1,000 bands on it, throw it in a safe. I got a stack of cash. It's weird. I've never been able to do that. Kind of enjoying it. I guess as I get a little older, I realize I've got probably everything I need. A little cash wouldn't be a bad idea. Blessing. Do I ever need it? Oh, it's a blessing.
That's not a bad idea. Rainy day fund, you never know.
That's the thing, it's, you know, I'm not an end of the world kind of person by any means, but I am so, like, worried about how fucking crazy people are. I mean, this, you get a power outage for 3 weeks. I think there would be chaos in the fucking streets because people are
so desperate.
They're just so dependent on every little thing, you know. They don't think about, you know,
repercussions.
Anything, right? That shit kind of bothers me. And I mean, that would all sort itself out pretty quickly, but I think people are such douchebags nowadays. You better have a few thousand dollars in your pocket, because, you know, I know, I got a lot of friends that, if they had to scrape $5 together, they'd have a hard time. They use their debit card for everything, and I'm like, you know, one of these days that might not work for a little while, you know? Full of fuel, give me 1,000 miles, or I got that, you know, I got a 10,000 kV generator in it. I think the thing's got maybe 200 hours on it total. I don't know how long I could run, but I bet I could go for, shit, weeks. And I always keep the water full, you know, just like, you know, in case the power went off a couple, 3 days, shit, I'd never skip a beat. I'd be sitting there watching TV if it was
watching the old tube.
Yeah,
I keep telling myself that I want to get those house generators. They're just so nice. I know, you've been around, you've seen outages the last week, 2 weeks, a month. You get hurricane areas fucking 2 months before this.
Yeah.
Around here, you don't have to give a fuck.
Right. And you got gas in the city, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah, who gives a shit? Just
lettery.
Suck it up.
Didn't get that long. I'd start to worry about people trying to break in and squat at your house.
They would. People are too, they're not independent enough anymore. You know, I used to be, when I was growing up in grade school, I remember, you know, every now and again you had a blizzard. You know, it'd be a couple of weeks where you couldn't get to the grocery store. You really couldn't get anywhere, you know. And if you'd luck, you had power. And if not, you know, you had enough firewood cut, you dealt with it. I don't think people get you. Most people couldn't get it. Go through 2 weeks. They'd have to get rescued.
Yeah.
And we never skipped a beat. I remember the blizzard of 78. It's like we couldn't get the doors open in the house for, I think, 3 days. And Dad ended up having to crawl out one of the windows, upstairs, go down onto the porch, into a pile of snow, and then start scooping it out from the outside. You couldn't get out of the house from the ground floor. None of the doors would come open. Shit, if that happened nowadays, fuck.
sub, we're done.